Good afternoon and welcome back to Victory in the Word. I'm your host for the day, Sarah Schallenberger from H22 Ministries, where we are about the purpose, the power, and the plans of God for your life and for mine as well. So welcome again. We are in the middle of our segment that we are doing on healing. And healing, we know, is one of my favorite topics. And it's something that has been given to us through Jesus for the entire body of Christ. So we've already done about 5 of these segments covering different topics of healing. And we've been talking about God's will to heal and different facets of how to pull it in. So we're just going to be continuing that today. But before we get into what we're going to be teaching, and you can see we already have the board up and we've got lots of good notes. And if you're at home and you are a student of the Word and you want to grab a notebook and grab a pen and write some of these verses down that we're going to be going over, I would invite you to go ahead and take a moment to go grab a pen and paper while I cover a little bit of business beforehand, and then we'll get into the teaching of the Word. So when we opened up today, I greeted you with a hello, but I also want to practice on you another type of a greeting. So this is a Neho Nong Hai, Sarah. And this is hello, I'm Sarah, and that's Cantonese. And so we are getting ready at our household to get me on an airplane and get over to Hong Kong in 2 weeks. And so this is part of our spoken for tour that we are starting, that the Lord has kind of opened the doors for us to go into that Hong Kong area. This was, I think, the picture that I showed last week, and I don't know if there's sometimes a glare on these laminated things, but this is actually a prophetic word that I got through one of my ministry friends, Bobby Connor, who was just in the Houston area last week at Victory Church here in Houston. And this was a word that he had given through this drawing. This is a drawing that he did 2 years ago about going and ministering to some of these young ladies over in the Asia area that have been trafficked. And so this is one of the components or ways that the Lord's been putting this particular trip together. So we'll be over there working with Dennis Balcom, who's been over there for over 45 years. He's a wonderful Holy Spirit revivalist and has been responsible for birthing hundreds and hundreds of churches in that China area. And he is still pastoring, him and his wife Kathy, who are from my old stomping ground, Oakland in California. So we'll be privileged to meet up with them, and we're going to get the opportunity to do some video with them that we'll be able to share here on Victory in the Word. So excited about that. The other groups that we'll be meeting with is Matt Friedman and his wife Sylvia, and they are with the Mekong group. Matt Friedman has worked for the United Nations over in Asia. This is in Nepal and in Cambodia and Vietnam and Laos, some of these areas, with programs against trafficking. He's currently working in the business sector, and so he's been responsible for teaching and giving instruction, educating business owners how to do business in Asia and in different parts of the world in order to protect their business from unknowingly hiring people that are in human slavery. So these are people that have been kidnapped or trafficked or have been forced to work without being paid or being paid very little. And so this is Matt Friedman in the Mekong group. And then our other friends we will be meeting up with are the Fisher family, and they have a wonderful church in Hong Kong as well. And if you've been watching the news, we know that that whole China area in Hong Kong has just been hit by what the newspapers are calling a super typhoon. And so for those of us that have walked through Hurricane Ike and Hurricane Harvey here in the Texas Gulf Coast area, those pictures that we're seeing on Facebook and in the news, those look very familiar, of all that damage and destruction that's done by water damage. And so we're very privileged and just believe it's the hand of the Lord moving in the timing of this particular trip, that I'll be over there on the ground bringing my boots with me and my gloves, and we'll be able to help with some of that cleanup. So we're excited about that. There's more information about that trip on my Facebook page. And if you're interested in sewing into that trip, I would love to have your prayer support, first of all. The goals of all of our trips are very specific in nature. It's to build the local church, it's to equip and encourage the body of Christ, and it's to make sure that and to do our part in getting that last day harvest out. Your prayers are our most valuable asset. If you understand the principle of sowing and reaping, and you would like to sow, and you have a heart to sow into that part of the world, we would welcome that sowing. Don't give us your tithe, but anything that you're willing to sow, we would will believe with you for a good return on that. One of the things I'm believing for in this trip is just that the one of the returns is that it helps other people to hear the call of God on their life. And so that's what we're believing the Lord for. So a lot of exciting things happening. And again, I know I've mentioned our friend Bobby Connor that was just in Victory Church in Houston. A lot of stuff going on locally. If you're familiar with the Houston area, another ministry, and we'll take some time maybe to highlight some of these, is Launch Houston. And that's a newer ministry organization, but that helps to birth and to intercessory team to help pull together ministries that the Lord has planting in this Houston area. And so there's a lot going on, and we're just privileged to be part of it and kind of just step in and do our part, and then the trust that the Lord puts all these pieces together. So we're going to continue talking about healing. Now, again, I always want to make an appeal or a reminder to the body of Christ about our foundation for even investing our time into learning about healing. And it comes from the foundation that it is God's will that He wants us healed. And we know that, of course, because heaven, there's no sickness in heaven. And Jesus' prayer was that He wanted it on earth as it is in heaven. We have the picture of the Garden of Eden. That was God's original design or His intent for mankind, which was no disease. So that's a good indicator of His will that there's no disease in us. And then there's all of the things that God provided along the way. Covenant of healing, the covenant He made with Abraham in Deuteronomy 28 included long life, strength, and health, included sickness and disease off of them. That's a good indicator that it's God's will to have healing. Jesus' 39 stripes. There's all sorts of things, and we'll go over some of those, but we want to really get that in the body of Christ, that it's a set mindset, that it's settled, that it is God's will to heal. If you're facing something either in your physical body currently, or you have, like I did, a family history that you know is lurking behind you, maybe you're in your 30s, maybe you're in your 20s, maybe you're still a teen, but you know that there's this history of disease that kind of is following you in your natural line, you want to settle in your heart now and today. The God's will is to have you be healed and then start picking up those tools and using them. If you're part of the body of Christ, like I was for many years, that attended a church that was not strong in healing, and you might have find yourself coming across these videos, or because we have the internet, you might find that you come across videos and services where healing's being preached or taught. There might be healing crusade meetings that you are viewing, and it might seem to go counter or not quite agree with what you're being taught in your local church. That happens. And so my encouragement to you is that when we're talking about any of the things of God, that our go-to is His Word. Regardless of what church you attend on a Sunday morning, the standard for the body of Christ has always been God's Word. And so when we have a question about healing, your best place to start, my best place to start, is to inquire directly of the Lord and to go straight to His Word. And then ask Him and say, Jesus, I'm going to You. I don't want man's opinion. I want Your opinion. What have You provided for me? And then if you are reading the Word and you're having a hard time pulling or seeing healing in the Word, then you ask Him, say, Jesus, I want to learn about healing. You bring to my path somebody that is your pick for me to learn or to sit under in order to learn about healing. And ask again the Lord to show you which ministry to put yourself under or to lend your ear to. And I say that because, again, when we're talking about the body of Christ, not the entire the body of Christ, there's a wide variety of revelation within the body of Christ on this one topic of healing. And regardless of where you or I are on that spectrum, we are still part of the body of Christ. And the best thing you can do when you're part of the body is to go to the Lord directly and to ask Him to teach you. The worst thing you can do, and what we don't want to see in the body of Christ, is people turning on one another and saying, that's not right. I don't agree with that. That's not right. I don't agree with that. That bickering inside the body of Christ is destructive, not just in the spiritual realm, but in the natural realm. And it gets played out on Facebook. It gets played out in the media. And it's a terrible, horrible witness for the lost. And so what we want to do in the body of Christ is we want all of our believers, all of our local churches, all of our pastors, all of our ministers encouraging their parishioners, their people that they are responsible for, to go straight to the Lord, straight to the Word, ask Him to teach them. And then when you have a question of something that maybe you're hearing being taught by a ministry outside of your local church, you inquire of the Lord and you ask Him to teach you. And then if you still have a question, you very politely raise it with that ministry. And you do it in a humble way and you say, thank you so much for your teaching. I love Jesus just like you love Jesus. I love the Word just like you love the Word. I see you're saying this. I thought it went this. Can you help me with this? And then if there's not a meeting of the minds, then you say, or a meeting of the hearts, you say, thank you so much. God bless you. And then you move on. So that is my spiel. And I say that again, because when we're ministering to the whole body of Christ. And we want the whole body of Christ healed. And part of healing is unity. It's the spirit of the unity and the bond of peace. And that's throughout the whole body. We want our whole body of Christ strong. So let's go ahead. And again, the good news about healing is that it's already been provided for us. So when we're talking about the issue of healing, we are never going to be in the position where we have to beg the Lord and say, will you, can you, will you? Because healing's been settled and it's already been technically done. So I have some of this. I would like to use, I'm a former teacher and what I taught was art. So I tend to be very visual. And so when the Holy Spirit gives me a picture in my mind of a way to communicate a spiritual truth, I do my best to get it translated and put down in a clear way so that you can try to grasp on what the Holy Spirit wants to teach with each of our segments. And so we're looking at the issue of confidence again, that God wants us healed, that we're not spending our time asking, is it your will, isn't your will? And then we're settling for ourselves once and for all when we were healed. And we'll talk about why that's so important in a little bit, but let's go and see when we were healed. So here we go, when we were healed. Now, we know that the plan of redemption was put, and the Bible says, the plan of redemption was laid before the foundations of the earth. So anything that God originally intended for mankind was in His heart and in His mind and in His spirit and in His thinking before the foundation of the world, okay? So we have here, the on this part of the timeline says when we were healed, okay? And that points down to a very specific time in history, okay, which was 2,000 years ago for us that are in 2018. This was the day and the time and the hour that those stripes were taken and that Jesus was on the cross, and then He rose from the dead. So this is the time period of when it happened. The question down here on the bottom, though, is how long has it been, or what is the parameter of time when healing's been available? We know when it was actually done, but how long, or when's the scope of time where healing has been available to mankind? And so again, well, the plan of God before the foundation of the earth. First time we see healing or wholeness or the lack of disease is in the very creation, when we read about Genesis and how God designed this earth and mankind to live in it. Garden of Eden, no sickness, no disease. So was healing available, health was available, healing wasn't needed, but health was there. So yes, it was available. Then we have the fall of man. Then we have, after the fall, Did God make a way for his people that were in covenant with him to receive healing? Was that available in the Old Testament? Yes, it was. And there was, I put these not in any particular chronological order, but just into what they came to me when I was thinking about this. And this is, yes, he made covenant. He made a covenant that has always included healing. Abraham, when you look at the covenant he made with Abraham, you find that in Deuteronomy 28. And Deuteronomy 28 outlines that we are given abundant life, that we are blessed, that sickness and disease is kept off of us, and that everything prospers about us, including our physical bodies, to the point of being blessed with longevity. So we have the covenant that was always provided healing in the Old Testament for the people of God. We have the temple, which carried the Shekinah glory and the presence of God. And we know that in his presence, there's no sickness. So it was always available through the ministry that was going on in the temple, the priests. There we had the ministry of the prophets in the Old Testament. We had men like Elijah and Elisha and Isaiah and those that were able to move, and they had the Spirit of the Lord upon them, and they moved in the gifts. And we know we've got lots of stories where they provided healing. Naaman the leopard's probably one of the most well known. And so we had the ministry of the prophets. That was a way that people could pull into healing from God. We had the balm of Gilead. So this was an actual balm that was located in different cities that people knew that when they were in covenant with God, they could go to certain locations and have the balm applied, and they would be healed. So this healing was always available. Healing was available to mankind through the ministry of Jesus. Even before Jesus died on the cross, Jesus healed on credit. He knew that he had faith in what he would accomplish in the cross and in that plan of redemption, and used that faith to produce healing. And he was spirit-filled. He had the Holy Spirit upon him, so he was operating in the gifts. And people were able to receive healing from God through Jesus's ministry. So that is always available. Then we have his 39 stripes, and that's the moment in time. Isaiah had told it 700 years ago beforehand. That was the moment in time, the Bible says, when we were healed. That was the exact time and date when that healing was done. It had always been available before that, but the healing that was done that we get to walk in was provided at a certain time, and that was the stripes, the cross, and the resurrection. Okay. So, but there, wait, there's more. So even after that, we're going in the time period here, we have the ministry of the disciples or the apostles. So we know as soon as they were spirit-filled, they were going around. Actually, before they were spirit-filled, the Lord had given them authority. Remember, he sends out those 72, and they go out and they cast out demons and they heal the sick. They do what their master told them to do. And so healing's available through those disciples. And then, of course, we have Pentecost, and in Pentecost, we've got the gifts of the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit poured out on the church, and many of those gifts, like words of knowledge, words of wisdom, the gifts of healing, faith for the working of miracles, those all can play a part and or directly or indirectly provide healing as well for the body of Christ. We have the written word after Jesus goes back into heaven. So we start having this being written. It says Holy Spirit inspired. We have the letters to the church. We have John's vision of the island of Patmos is put in the book of Revelation. And we have it all compiled into the written word. And so now we have people that have the actual life and substance of God, including healing, in a written form. So people can be pulling healing in from the written word. We have the Reformation with Dr. Martin Luther. This is my tradition background as Lutheran. And so he, of course, brings into the body of Christ that we are saved by grace, and that we go directly, our intercessor is the Lord Jesus himself, that we go directly up to him, and the Holy Spirit teaches us the word. So people can pull in healing at this point in time. And then, of course, we're walking in the last days where there's revival and a tremendous move of God that's going on through the Holy Spirit and the word and in the church right now in the days that we're walking in. So there's all sorts of venues from Garden of Eden to where we are now. There has never been a time where healing has not been available. And so our stance in history, we locate, where are you in history? Where am I in history? Remember, we're here for such a time as this. We're here. This is where us. So the question is, when you go up to Jesus, who is lives, has lived before the foundation of the earth. So here he is. He was alive during this period, this period, this period, all these different periods that are here. Jesus is living through all these. He's eternal. So he's alive doing all of these. So here he is. Here we are. We go up to him and we say, Jesus, will you heal me today? I'm in 2018. Will you heal me today? And Jesus, who was up here, will turn to us and say, Sarah, Joe, Sally, whoever you, Harold, you know, I already did. Did you hear what I said? So we go, here we are. There's Jesus. He's always existed. He's all never changed. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Here we are, 2018. Jesus, will you heal me? Sarah, Joe, Mark, Sally Sue, Gretchen, Bob, Naomi, I already did. I already did. That's his response. I already did. And then if we need a visual, if we were to have a vision of him, and if we were to have him come up to us and we ask him in person and we say, Jesus, will you heal me? And we're in 2018. He turns around. He puts his robe down. He points to the scars. And then he turns around. He says, I already did. So you can have a chart in front of you. You can have a word in front of you. You can write that chart down at your home yourself. You can read it. And anytime you ask him, if you are living in 2018, will you? He'll say, I already did. I already did. When was that healing? And then or just if you want to continue the timeline, for those of you that are watching and you're a particular detailed person and you're saying, she didn't mention the last thing on the end. So right here in pencil, is a heaven. So this is where in heaven, of course, there's no healing, but there's no sickness in heaven. So is healing or wholeness available? Yes. Even after Jesus returns, it's available in heaven. And then will it be available in the millennium? Yes, it will be. So there's never a time where God has not provided the ability for people, mankind, you and me, to be healed. Never. When was it done, though? It already has been done. The work's been done. Why is that important? Well, again, it's a confidence factor. It's you can tap into healing in any of these areas. But for us living in 2018, it's the confidence of knowing the work's already been done. And so what we're doing when we're talking about healing is we're talking about enforcing something that's already been given to us. This is when you receive Jesus as your Savior. The Bible says that the word sozo, that salvation, that the Bible, the word for salvation that the Bible uses, sozo, includes healing and wholeness and wellness in your mind, wellness in your heart, physical wellness, prosperity. Remember, the Lord delights in the prosperity of his servants. And so this is all included. The day that you received Jesus, you might have received him in 2003. You might have received him as your Savior in 2011. And when you believed in your heart and you confessed with your mouth and you received him as Savior, and at that very moment, what was available to you, whether it was taught to you at that moment or whether you understood it at the moment or not, that just as you received him as your Savior, he made a way for you to also receive him as your healer. And so just as we're particular with our mouth of receiving him as our Savior, Jesus, come into my life. I take you as my Savior. We need to be and we get to be that particular about him as our healer. Jesus, I receive you as my personal healer. Me, Sarah Schallenberger, with my line of my particular family history, I receive you, Jesus, as my healer of this, of that, of this, of that, of this, of that, and that. Anything that concerns me, Jesus, you're my healer, so I'm healed. It's Exodus 15:26. So this was just a short overview, and I trust that this was helpful in helping to get a mindset and a heart faith, and if you already have it, to have it strengthened in you of when Jesus was heals you, that as you're speaking to Jesus, who is real and who's alive, you're speaking to him as the person that's already accomplished it. And so when you're speaking to him, you're saying, thank you, Jesus, that by your stripes, I already have been healed, already. Already done. You already did it. So thank you. I believe it. I receive it. Thank you for showing me anything I need to learn about pulling that in. And thank you for that you've given me tools to push out disease. Thank you for doing it. And of course, we know all the rest of our segments were hitting on very specific components of healing. So in our next segment, we'll be talking about speaking God's word and how that's one of our venues that we've been given to pull in what Jesus has already done. If you do not know Jesus as your Savior, today, the Bible says, is the day of salvation. And so I would make an appeal to you and invite you just to wherever you are, in your office, in your home, maybe listening in your car, to speak to him directly and say, Jesus, I know that I've sinned. I've sinned against you and I've sinned against man. I have not always done the right thing or said the right thing, Lord, and I know that I have guilt or sin inside of me, and so I ask for your forgiveness. I thank you, Lord, that you died on a cross for my sins 2,000 years ago, made not only salvation but healing available for me. I repent of my sin and I ask you to come in and to cleanse me of all unrighteousness and ask you and I make you King and Lord of my life. The Bible says that when you ask him, his response is always yes. That actually he's been pulling on you since the day before you were, the day you were in your mother's womb and the day you were born. He's never stopped pulling on you, and he's been looking for you to receive him as your Savior so that he can reunite you to a good Heavenly Father and impart to you eternal life. Never can be separated from him. Eternal resurrection life, Zoe life on the inside of you that has the ability to overcome anything that you need to face or walk or have walked through or have faced or are facing or will face. That Zoe life is given to you and to me to overcome anything that's on this earth. And it's eternal. What God gives us can't be taken away. He loves you very much, and if you've prayed that prayer today and you do not have a strong local church or would like us to help you locate a local church, your two go-tos are the Word of God. You need to be have a Bible and start reading the Bible every day, and then you need to be planted in a local church. If you don't have a local church where you're at, I would invite you to contact me in the information at the bottom of your screen, and we will connect with you, and we will do our due diligence to help you connect with one in your area. So Jesus loves you, and he has now, when you receive him, you get put into his family, which includes being put in a local church. So thank you for your watching. We just continue to thank you for viewing these segments. If you know of someone that's dealing with a healing need, or you have somebody that's a student of the Word that you know has struggled with understanding and believing for this, please share these segments with them. Our heart is to minister and to help people get from point A, whatever that point is, to point B. So if they already know God is good and that he loves them, we want to add to that that God is also the healer. So that's all for today, and we'll see you in the next segment of Victory in the Word. Thank you so much, and God bless you.